Welcome to the Network Engineering Video Blog. I am your host, Michael Crane. I was going to make a video about some testing, since we've done video, a training video and a little automation video. But I wanted to show you how not to ship a Cisco 3845 router. I bought one of these on eBay. And I just wanted to show you how this was packaged and why this was a complete fail. So let's get started. So according to the spec sheet on Cisco, the dimensions of the 3845 are 5.5 inches by 17.25 by 16. So, and this box is 6 inches by 19 inches by 18.5 inches. So that means that the box is only 1 to 2 more inches larger than the actual router, which is a big problem, because that means that there is probably hardly any packing in this. And as you can see, I have not opened this yet. And if you look, it looks like the box was basically taped to the outside of the router, which is not really acceptable either. Let's unpack this thing and see what damage it's had. Oh, and also, I'm almost pretty sure it is damaged, because if you listen, well, you can hear it rattling around in there. And you can hear, I hear pieces of plastic banging around in there. I don't know if you can hear it on the video or not, but as you can see, it's had a pretty hard shipping. And you know, everybody knows that the FedEx people, I think, you ship this, and it doesn't matter, FedEx, UPS, or the Post Service, they throw these boxes around like footballs. And so most people know that you have to ship them with quite a bit of padding, especially on a device. This device with nothing in it, according to the spec sheet, weighs 45 pounds, which is very heavy. So yeah, I'm expecting to see some damage when we go to open this up. And so let's open it up. So when I flip this back over, this fell out of it. It looks like it's a typical Cisco green, probably came off the front faceplate. So yeah, I'm 100% convinced it's damaged now. Let's open it up. And well, there you go. It has absolutely zero packing. And as I suspected, this box, this old Amazon box, was basically just taped around the router. As you can see, we got another broke piece in here. Let's take a quick inspection of this and see if we can see what damage there is on the outside. Well, you can see right here for that piece that I, oh yeah, here you go. So it looks like this thing got thrown on its side. You can see the rack mount is all broke, and the ear, I mean. And looks like this piece here came off there. I don't know where that piece went. Maybe it's, oh yeah, it came off the other side. Here's that little piece I was showing you earlier. So looks like this got thrown on its head while it was in shipping, and that's what I'm hearing rattle around. Here's the other broke side right here. As you can see, it's been well damaged. This one doesn't have a bent ear though, so I guess that's good. And the back cards, let's see. Well, you can see this right here. This handle is supposed to be pulled straight out, but it's all bent up, probably because it was thrown on its backside as well. I don't know if that's broke, but yeah, I mean, to really know, well, cosmetically it's very damaged, so I mean, that's bad. And I realize I didn't pay a lot of money for this router, and the shipping, they only charged $20 for shipping. I would have been willing to pay them an extra $20 for packaging had I known this was going to be the result. Okay, so let's take a look at the eBay auction and see if there are some warning signs that I was going to get in trouble on this, and we'll also look at the condition. When I looked at this, I did notice that the shipping was cheap. $21 is pretty cheap. I've paid double that to ship smaller devices. So that was good, and it was coming from Keller, Texas, which is pretty close to me. It's like in Fort Worth, and I'm kind of in Dallas, so we're relatively close to each other. So I was like, okay, well, that sounds okay. Everything looks okay there. And if you look at the router itself, you can see that there is no damage on the left side next to the rack mount ear. And if you look at the right side, you can see there's no damage on that side either. In fact, the whole front case looks very, very nice. The top looks okay. It's not scratched. If we look at the back, if you look at the back, you can see there's not really any damage along the edges. You can notice that card handle that was bent up, and you know, from the shipping, it is not bent up here in this picture, and everything looks pretty good. So aesthetically, it looked good, and it looks clean. It's got the compact flash card installed in there. That looks good. Everything, you know, looks to be in really nice shape. So, what else could we see? So, I did notice that the feedback was pretty low. He only had 6 positive feedbacks, but like I said, he was kind of local, so, you know, I kind of was giving him a break on that. And another thing I noticed, and I just kind of, you know, chalked it up to an oversight, was if you go into the description, you can see that the description is not of a 3845 router, but of a Cisco AC1200, which is a firewall or something. I'm not even familiar with it. So, yeah, I'm not exactly sure. It says 3845 here and AC1200 here. I'm I don't know what that is. That was a head scratcher, but I just figured he copied and pasted this post for another post that he was doing and spaced out on that. But there's sometimes there's a reason why people only have 6 feedbacks. I didn't look to see how long he'd had his account. That's kind of a red flag if someone just opened it
which means they might have had another account and closed it because they're getting bad feedback or something like that. I don't know. For right now, I'm going to give the guy a benefit of doubt. I haven't contacted him yet, but I will and see what he wants to do about this. And I'll probably check back in with everybody and kind of let everyone know what happens. You know, this sort of thing really gives eBay a black eye. So, you know, I guess I'm happy that I did get it. Of course, like I said, he is local. So I doubt if he's going to run off with my money. But that shipping was, you know, that was a complete fail. The packing for that. And to get the product that was in really excellent condition, at looking at it, and to get it so beat up and broken is a real shame. It really is.
I thought it was kind of funny, this box that's been all hacked apart from Amazon.com actually had something of interest on the side. It says, rate this packaging. I'll give it a rating. Here's my rating. 2 thumbs down.